Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Devontae, and I sacrificed my time so you don't have to. What the fuck are they doing up there in AEW headquarters, bro? I want to know who the fuck is signing off on the decision-making in that company, because they are so ass-backwards. I swear to God, I shit you not, man. Why do I have a feeling everybody who's signing off on these contracts, on these deals, on this decision-making, I swear to God, this is like Tony Khan's whole AOL chat room circa 1996 discussing what's going to happen at the next New Japan Pro Wrestling event, right? I shit you not, everybody in upper echelon management is all his friends in his chat room during the time. This makes no sense whatsoever. So I got some links down in the description box, and I'm going to notate each one for you guys. And we're going to take it in chronological order, and we'll get to the ending. You're probably going to ask yourself, what the fuck are you talking? Bear with me for a moment, okay? So this is the first one. I don't really have to read it. I just wanted to notate something for you guys. You can read the article if you want to. It's just to present a little bit more context real quick. So from my understanding, as of right now, Kevin Owens' contract, I'll read this paragraph for you real quick. WWE immediately retained Kevin Owens by signing a multi-year deal with him. Under this contract, mind you, this article was written about a month ago, he enjoys an annual salary of $2 million. In addition to such an impressive paycheck, he also gets bonuses from the company. He enjoys a profit share from merchandise sales and pay-per-view appearances, reports Sportskeeda. Now we know why the former Universal Champion wants to stay. So that's just to give you a bit of context as far as what kind of money is Kevin Owens making at the moment in WWE. Well, apparently his contract is coming up, right? And you may be saying to yourself, oh, okay, well, I'm going to assume, especially with the Young Bucks being in the, you know, ops corner, Kevin Owens is now once again having to weigh his options as to if he wants to stay in WWE or if he wants to finish off his career in AEW. And I don't know the decision making that they're making down there. They turned down Kevin Owens. I'll read the article for you, and then I'll talk about my opinion. And I want to talk about one more thing, if you don't mind. So this is from E-Wrestling News. This is coming from, I believe, earlier today. Yeah. Report: AEW passed up the chance to sign Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens has been a key player in WWE since his NXT debut in 2014 and has achieved several title victories throughout his career. Despite his success, Owens has yet to extend his contract with WWE as his current deal approaches its end. In December of 2021, Owens agreed to a multi-year contract with WWE amid speculation about his future with the company. However, in an interview in May of 2023, Owens disclosed that he had 9 months remaining on his current contract, which is set to expire in early 2025. Owens recently confirmed that his contract status has not changed and has less time left on his current deal. This means that Owens has yet to sign a contract extension with WWE. According to a report from the Wrestling Observer newsletter, when Owens signed his current 3-year deal, it was one of the most lucrative contracts in the company and the wrestling industry, with salaries ranging between $2.25 million and $3 million annually, as we just read previously. AEW had knowledge of Owens' contract situation, but they chose not to compete with WWE's offer back then. However, in recent years, there has been a significant change in the industry, with salaries increasing, notably as evidenced by contracts such as Swerve Strickland, we'll get to him in a minute, which exceeds Owens' previous agreement. The report states Owens' contract, which was a 3-year deal, which at the time of signing was one of the highest in the company and in wrestling, will be due in early 2025. At the time, AEW was aware and did an attempt to match his big offer, which tells you something about how salaries have escalated in the last 2+ years, because if it was this year, there is a good chance they would have tried to match the deal. The Strickland deal is well ahead of the Owens deal, which at the 2.5, 3 million, around that range, over the 3 years was considered huge at the time. So they passed up on Kevin Owens, right? And that's not that big of a deal, right? In the end of the day, that's their decision. Maybe they felt they didn't have any stories prepared for him. Maybe they felt that, okay, the money that he's making at the moment, we can't match that, because why try to match that when we have no spot for him? Like I said, as the article right here mentioned, Swerve Strickland's contract is ridiculous. So let me read that article for you real quick. This is also coming from Well, actually, this is F4O Online, so, but it's still related to the Wrestling Observer. But check this out. Some of the details of that deal, mind you, this is talking about Swerve Strickland's new deal that he just signed with Tony Khan. Some of the details of that deal are now known, courtesy of this week's Wrestling Observer newsletter. Dave Meltzer reported that the new deal will keep Strickland in AEW through September of 2029 and is one that financially puts the now former champion in striking distance of the very top stars of wrestling. Meltzer, it was hinted to him that the contract is in the range of the recent contracts of Mercedes Moné and Kazuchika Okada as far as what they signed with AEW, but not in the realm of the deal's top stars like Roman Reigns, Cody Rhodes, and Randy Orton have in WWE. Meltzer noted that the Strickland deal came together a few weeks with an announcement saved for All In. He also reported that WWE tried to make a play for the Strickland and Prince Nana act. Fucking goddamn ass, I swear to God. It's unknown if that is related to the contract tampering that Khan claims is still happening. Strickland first signed with AEW in March of 2022 after being cut from WWE in November of 2021 as part of the company's mass releases. Nana, a Ring of Honor regular, reportedly re-signed with AEW for multiple years last September. So, that's the end of the article right there. Now, you may be asking yourselves, what's the big deal? Although, I'm pretty sure you know what the big deal is. It's not the fact that they didn't re-sign Kevin Owens. I don't have a problem with that. You don't have to re-sign anyone that you don't want to re-sign. My problem stems from the fact that, let me see if I have a bigger understanding of what the hell's going on here. So Kevin Owens is not worth the money, right? That in itself is already telling because you have a person, which mind you, I'm not a big Kevin Owens fan. I don't really care about him. I think he's a bit of a tryhard. I think, honestly, who cares? I really don't see that much inside him. But that's just my own subjective, you know, factoring in regards to looking at someone like a Kevin Owens. The metrics in itself, as far as his years as a competitor, his name value, that doesn't lie. If he went to AEW, Kevin Owens would by far be one of the most notable superstars in that company. By far. Not even fucking close. Maybe even top five. And it's really not even fucking close. But it is what it is. You don't want to sign Kevin Owens because you feel you don't have a spot for him. There's nothing wrong with that. My problem, however, and mind you, this is coming from a guy who likes Swerve Strickland. I like Swerve Strickland more than I like Kevin Owens by far, and it's not even close. But are you really willing to sit here and tell me at this very moment, Swerve Strickland, mind you, a guy, when you were to look at the ratings, and again, I like Swerve. I'm just painting up the metrics for you guys, showing you how unbiased I am. I like Swerve. Can't get over the fact that the guy is not a draw. Facts, he's not a draw. Compared to Kevin Owens, he's not a draw. Owens is a bigger draw than Swerve Strickland. Now, you can map that out. You could say, well, WWE, the propaganda machine behind them, whatever the case may be. But numbers don't lie. At the moment, Kevin Owens is a bigger draw than Swerve Strickland. More people are aware of who Kevin Owens is than Swerve Strickland. That's just facts. You can't dispute that. I don't like Kevin Owens. I like Swerve Strickland. He ain't a bigger name than Kevin Owens. Facts. You can't dispute that at all. So one will tell you, okay, if you don't want to hire Kevin Owens, understandable, but why in the fuck is Swerve Strickland getting, and mind you, this has nothing to do with Swerve as far as him not getting the bag. Get the bag. I have nothing to do with, you know, I have no problem with Swerve Strickland as far as what he's doing. I'm just questioning it as a fan, as far as looking from the outside looking in. I'm trying to map out what the hell is going on here. This has nothing to do with Swerve. Motherfucker, there's a bag in your face. You better grab that shit, or I'll make a video about you not grabbing the bag and be a complete fucking retard. That's not the argument. My argument is, so Kevin Owens is not worth the money in comparison to his WWE contract. Let's just take it at the high end of $3 million, right? I mean, most people are saying it's probably in the $2 million range, but let's take it at the highest end, $3 million. Now, as we talked about plenty of times before, Mercedes Moné is making upwards to how much is her Mercedes contract? I think I talked about this before. I think it's like $10 million, something like that, for the next 3 years. So she's making every bit of around $4 million, right? Let's just say that between $3.5 to $4 million at the highest end, right? And Kazuchika Okada, as we've learned, is making $13.5 million every 3 years. So let me see if I have a great understanding for this. Kazuchika, because I know most people are going to probably bring up the age thing in reference to Swerve Strickland. I know people are going to probably bring up, oh, well, his body isn't as worn down as Kevin Owens. Quick question. I'm very curious. How old is Kazuchika Okada? Let me look this up real quick. We're going to look this up in real time. Kazuchika Okada is 36 years old. Okay. How old is Kevin Owens? He's got to be like 38 or 37, right? Something along the lines of that. Kevin Owens is... oh, he's 40. He just turned 40. So let me see if I understand this real quick. So Kazuchika Okada is about 4 years younger. And he's going to turn 37 in a few months, by the way. So let's just say 3 years younger. So Kazuchika Okada, 3 years younger than Kevin Owens, who has been wrestling in New Japan Pro Wrestling probably longer than Kevin Owens' entire fucking career, right? Being exaggerated, I'm speaking hyperbole. But my point being is, he's been doing the hard, strong style stuff for a long time. One can make an argument his body is way more broken down than a Kevin Owens, theoretically, right? Right? Let me see if I understand this. Kazuchika Okada is worth nearly $15 million, right? Kevin Owens, you can't compare a contract to his? And then you're here telling me that Swerve Strickland is within the range of Okada's and Mercedes' insane fucking contract deal. So, let me see if I get this. I disagree brutally with Monet's contract. I disagree brutally with Okada's contract. Like I said, have nothing to do with them getting the bag. That's their personal perspective as far as, or not personal perspective, that's their personal life as far as what they're doing with their money. I don't care. As a matter of fact, I endorse them getting that back. It's strictly speaking from an optical standpoint looking at this. Mercedes and Okada are getting tens of millions of dollars as far as the overall contract. You tell me that Swerve is within their range. Meaning, Swerve is also getting tens of millions of dollars in his contract. If not tens of millions, we're talking about super fucking close. Probably around the $8 to $9 million range, right? But Kevin Owens? Kevin Owens is not worth matching to Swerve's contract? Am I hearing this right? Because at least with Okada and Monet, horribly overrated, one can make an argument on the grand scheme of things that, okay, you can have a debate in the IWC as far as who you feel is a bigger name between a Kevin Owens and a Sasha Banks, right? I think in the grand scheme of things with Okada, that's a little bit tricky because he's wrestled mostly in New Japan Pro Wrestling and not a lot of superstars in WWE know who the fuck Kazuchika Okada is, right? That's a tricky argument. He is one of the biggest names in professional wrestling, but outside of the North American region, right? Like I said, it's an argument that you can make. I can understand where both sides are coming from when at least compared to a Kevin Owens, right? Who's relatively a big name in WWE, but I think a relative mid-card big name in WWE is about as known as an average New Japan Pro Wrestling star who's in the main event scene. That's just my opinion. Mercedes is more of a, you know, that's more of an argument because it's essentially Sasha Banks versus Kevin Owens. You can argue the level of that. There's no way you can argue the level of that with Swerve Strickland. I'm sorry, you can't argue that with the level of Swerve Strickland. That's not possible. That's not possible at all, bruh. And they will sit here and they would try to gaslight you and tell you that he's on that level. He's not. He's not. Like I said, this is like some type of incentive structure for a Swerve Strickland that Tony Khan is just rewarding him for it. That's another story. I get it. But reward him to the degree that you're willing to break the bank for Swerve Strickland? Maybe if, and here's the thing, it's not to say that Swerve's talent couldn't be cultivated enough, were pushed enough, he could be in that position. I'm not saying his talents, they don't acquiesce that type of money, but you haven't used his talents to the fullest capabilities to get that return on investment. Like, I'm not understanding how someone like a Kevin Owens can't get a contract in comparison to his current deal in WWE, but someone like a Swerve can be in the range of a Mercedes and a Okada, who they themselves don't deserve their contract. He's just spending money for the sake of spending money based off of his favoritism. That's it. It's just based off of favoritism. I have no reasoning to believe that these people who are making the money that they're making, you can't compare it to Kevin Owens? Like I said, if there's like a personal perspective as to how you feel about this, look, dude, at the end of the day, you're rich as fuck. You can do whatever you want to do with your money. It's just, again, I mentioned this word earlier, optically looking at the situation. You can't sit here on one hand and then say, oh, well, we have to fucking rely on this cable television deal in order to keep us up afloat. But then on the other hand, when you're presenting a legitimate talent that could probably help you do some numbers on your television show, at least for the time being, because he's an actual name, you pass up on him, fine, your prerogative, but then you sit here and then you justify other contracts that apparently are making upwards to what, probably what? He's making $2 million, right? On the high end, $3 million. So let's just say certain talents like Kazuchika is probably making five times as much money as Kevin Owens. Kazuchika Okada is making not like say $3 million compared to $4 million. No. He's making five times as much money nearly as a Kevin Owens. And hell, if he's really making $2 million, he's making seven times more money than a Kevin Owens. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. How you can bitch, complain, groan, and moan about, well, we need to get this cable television deal in order to keep us afloat. But then you fucking spend money like water coming out of a faucet for talent who ain't gonna fucking do anything in regards to putting you in a position to get that fucking contract deal. But then you have a talent who at the very least would do more than these talents as far as pushing you closer to this television deal. You can't even match his contract. Match. Meaning, probably Kevin Owens is looking for something around the ballpark of $5 million. Probably around that ballpark, right? But a Mercedes Moné can get double of that, right? But a Kazuchika can get nearly triple of that, right? It makes no sense to me whatsoever. You know what I'm starting to think right now also? You know, I make all these comparisons to Tony Khan and his position as far as how he feels about these wrestlers. I'm going to run something by you guys real quick. And you tell me, nah, Devonta, you probably think you're too deep into this. I noticed that a lot of people that he's signing, as far as their persona is considered, and maybe this could just be a complete coincidence, right? But you guys notice that the people with the high-end deals that we're starting to notice, people like the Young Bucks, people like Kazuchika Okada, people like Mercedes Moné, people like Swerve Strickland, are you guys noticing a pattern here? Am I tripping? Look at their gimmicks. Look at Kazuchika's his gimmick, his Rainmaker gimmick, right? Look at someone like the Young Bucks, the EVPs, right? They also have money falling from the sky. Look at Mercedes Moné, the CEO. Look at Swerve Strickland coming in with these fur coats and these and his rapper persona. Then look at Kevin Owens. Then look at Kevin Owens in comparison. Group in all those guys and look at the average everyday man like Kevin Owens as far as the aesthetic is considered, right? I swear to God, this is going to sound crazy when I say this, bruh. It's not just the big man complex that Tony Khan is probably feeling upon himself, because I've always been saying for the longest that maybe this motherfucker was bullied and that's why he doesn't want to put any onus on the big man as far as having him rep his company, as far as presenting larger than life talents. He wants people that look like him. I'll go beyond that and I'll say right now, currently, I swear to God, he has this personality where he just wants to buy his friends. He wants to buy the people who look cool to be around him. That's what it feels like. Like, bruh, I can't think of, you ever guys ever, I don't know, you probably watch it, I don't know. Have you guys ever seen Fairly Odd Parents? Or the Fairly Odd Parents? There's an early episode, one of the first ever episodes, right? Where Timmy wishes that he was cool, right? And he has all these fancy clothes on and everything like that. And he essentially buys all his friends, right? He uses wishes in order to make up for the fact that, you know, he doesn't have the money to buy all this stuff for his friends, right? But that's what it feels like. Tony Khan feels like Timmy Turner in that situation where he's buying all his friends. Whereas a Kevin Owens is like, you know, AJ or the bald kid, who I can't remember his name right now at the moment. Like, his two friends right there are Kevin Owens. Whereas, like, I mean, dude, just match my contract. And I got bigger name value than most of these guys right here. But, yeah, but Kevin Owens, have you seen how you look? I don't know if I can have you next to me in these pictures, man. It's kind of crazy, you feel me? I mean, Mercedes, I mean, she looks like this. And, you know, Swerve, he looks like that. And, you know, the Young Bucks, look at how they look. And Kazushka, he looks kind of cool, too. I mean, honestly, if it wasn't for the fact that Bryan Danielson did a main event so much WrestleManias and we can sell merchandise up the wazoo when using him, I probably wouldn't hire him either because he doesn't have that aesthetic that coincides with what the fuck I want going on currently in my company when it comes to the aesthetic of how I look with these guys in the picture. You know, plus I kind of like going to cocktail parties and I don't want to go by myself. You know, when I was a nerdy geek back in, you know, my private high school with the rest of the billionaire prep kids, I don't know, man, I just never was able to fit in. I didn't know how to buy them because how can I buy them when they're already rich? But now that I have more money than most of these people combined, I can buy them. I can buy them to be my friends. Kevin, I mean, again, you don't look like them, and you look kind of boring. You have a family, all this other boring shit. I don't know, man. I don't know. Can you get a little bit more cooler? And then maybe I probably match your contract with the rest of the people that I bought? That's the kind of feeling. That, I mean, I know people are going to be like, well, Devonta, you're reaching. Okay, that's fine. I'm still gonna think that way. That's how I feel personally looking at the situation. But nevertheless, though, let me hear your thoughts down in the comment section below. Do you think Tony Khan's a complete dipshit? Do you think he's a... Well, you guys think he's a dipshit. Do you think he's a dipshit for this decision? You probably think he's a dipshit for this decision. Does AEW have the right to complain going forward knowing that they make decisions like this? Again, not saying at all that Kevin Owens is owed a spot on AEW. It's just crazy to me how a guy like this could be passed upon, but Swerve Strickland could be making money upwards to tens to millions of dollars in the same range as a Kazushika Okada and a Mercedes Moné, who they themselves are making money that they have yet to prove that they have deserved. I'm not the crazy one here. I'm just the one reflecting off the numbers, looking at the popularity, and asking questions that I know most AEW fans are going to tell me. So why do you care about the numbers? The metrics? Oh, here we go again, Devonta. Oh, you're shitting on AEW. Can you just answer the fucking question for once in y'all motherfucking lives? As always, my name is Devonta, and I'll be catching you guys later. If not later on tonight, if anything else blows up, I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow for WWE. Bash at Berlin. Deuces and a P. Eyes.